Jim Thorpe.
It is July 1912. King Gustaf of Sweden officiates at the opening of the newly built Olympic Stadium in Stockholm. It is the sixth revival of the modern Olympic Games. It was the year Hannes Kolomainen of Finland won three gold medals in the 5,000 meters, 10,000 meters, and cross country. But his achievement was surpassed by an American Indian, Jim Thorpe, who won the five-event pentathlon and then would attempt to win the first Olympic decathlon ever held. The decathlon was designed to epitomize the Olympic theme, Sidious, Altius, Fortius, swifter, higher, stronger. Jim Thorpe was so supreme, the second place finisher was more than 800 points behind, the greatest margin in Olympic decathlon history. Today, Thorpe's name cannot be found officially in the record books. He had to return his gold medals when it was determined that he violated the amateur Olympic code by accepting money as a semi-professional baseball player a year before the games. Jim Thorpe's roommate, himself a silver medal winner in the 1500 meter run in Stockholm, was Abel Kiviat of the United States.
I room with him. The best-natured guy in the world. He was so nice, so pleasant. Big overgrown country kid, you know. Weighed about 175 to 180, stripped. 5'11" and a fraction. And they said he had a neck of 19 and a quarter inches. Like a wrestler. And he walked that way, chest out. I think the Thorpe was the greatest athlete that ever lived. There isn't anything he couldn't do. All he had to see someone do something. He'd hesitate, look, and he'd almost duplicate it, almost instantly.
Thorpe's outstanding score held until the 1928 games in Amsterdam. There, Paavo Urheilu, a 26-year-old farmer from Finland, set a new decathlon record. This is Paavo Urheilu today. He was born on this farm in the year 1902. He would work the land during the day, and in the evening, the farm would become his training ground in preparation for the Amsterdam Games.
I was able to practice with a real discus, javelin and shot put. I would throw them from this spot as far as I could. Then I would walk the distance to where it landed, and I knew approximately how far I had thrown. I cut down one of the trees out there and made a pole to practice for the pole vault. I also made my own hurdles. I did not know whether they were the right height. My farm became my training track. I calculated that the rock out there was about 200 meters from here. So I used to run back and forth to practice for the 400 meters and 1500 meters. I did not think I was so outstanding breaking Jim Thorpe's record. His training conditions were even worse than mine. I knew I was going to win the gold medal in Amsterdam. I would read the newspapers and find out how my competition was doing, but they didn't know how well I was doing, so I knew I would win.
The most famous Olympic decathlon champion since Thorpe in the pre-World War II era was Glenn Morris of the United States. He moved to worldwide prominence with his record-breaking performance at the Berlin Games of 1936. There, United States decathlon athletes won gold, silver, and bronze medals. He would be the last Olympic decathlon champion for more than a decade. 3 years after his victory, World War II began, and two Olympiads would be canceled.